Hey guys, my name is Dr. Joel Rosen. I am the Adrenal Fatigue Recovery Ninja, and today I want to talk to you about depression and genetics. Today I did a review for a genetic review for a mother of a 15-year-old child who is on Prozac and is having a tough time with depression. And so here's what I want to do. I want to go over as if you did a genetic test. You know that MTHFR and the genetics and polymorphisms have something to do with your depression, and you want to get some information out of that. And I think this is going to be a really, really enlightening video for you. It's going to be complicated, but I'm going to try to make it as easy as possible. So what we do is we explain, first of all, there are three possible chances or three possible outcomes when you do a genetic test. You can have a minus minus, a plus minus, or a plus plus. So a minus minus is when both parents don't inherit any or pass down any altered efficiency in the genes. The genes copy the enzyme and all is well, meaning it sort of photocopies the enzyme and produces a replication of that enzyme. With a plus minus gene, the enzyme isn't replicated effectively because moms or dads, but not both, the gene is altered. And when it reads the enzyme, it let's say for every 10 swipes that you read it, only 8 or 7 are typically gonna be good. And when plus plus, both parents pass that down, and that means that both genes are altered. So when it goes to replicate that enzyme, maybe 2 or 3 swipes for every 10 swipes that you do are going to be good. And that's going to be a problem because ultimately there are things that run in the family. There are family history of depression, anxiety, mood disorders, compulsions, addictions, autoimmunity, stuff like that. So what I wanted to do is talk about the excitatory, so we'll call that plus 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 plus, that's the dopamine side of things, and then we have the inhibitory, which is the serotonin side of things. So now if you go on a selective serotonin reuptake inhibitor, something like Prozac, what that's going to do is that's going to try to shut down the enzymes, especially MAO-A or SALT1A, to slow down the clearance of serotonin so it lasts longer. They do have dopamine reuptake inhibitors, but typically for depression, we go on serotonin reuptake inhibitors. So what I did today was I explained to this patient that her son, he's got a lot of polymorphisms or genetic susceptibilities where they're plus plus, plus plus, meaning both parents handed out the altered efficient gene. In COMT and PNMT, that's a big doozy, meaning it's not really allowing for dopamine to clear out of there. So what you have is you have sort of dopamine overfilling, and that's going to be too much excitatory. On the flip side, he had no problems, minus minus, for his serotonin things. So what does that mean? Or serotonin clearance. So what does that mean? It means if he's gonna take a selective serotonin uptake inhibitor for enzymes that are already working fine, then potentially he's gonna increase his level of serotonin, and that's gonna help him make him feel better. However, the problem is actually in the other side of the pool, where he has too much excitatory and not enough inhibitory. And that can create anxiety, mood disorders, isolations, pain, thrill-seeking behaviors, all that type of stuff. And so what was really interesting about this was he had all of these things going on, and there's other problems as well. He has potentially an iron deficiency. He also has an MTHFR, which is going to slow down the making of those neurotransmitters, both dopamine and serotonin. And if that's the case, if he has an MTHFR, then taking the SSRI could be helpful because he's not making a lot of the neurotransmitter to get into the pool. So of course you're gonna wanna, you know, allow that pool to hang out longer and make you feel better. But the problem was he was clear on this. He was doing a really good job. Now, the problem also was we didn't have a test for iron. he could potentially not be absorbing his protein, so maybe he's not absorbing his tryptophan. Or if he has an inflammatory mechanism, then the lack of iron, the problem with the MTHFR, and the fact that he's clearing out his hormones too quickly, plus the fact that he has an infection, is causing the nutrients that would otherwise go into the serotonin pool to not go in there. And that could be a huge problem. But here's the thing once again. He had a plus plus BHMT. He had a plus plus MAT. He had a plus plus MTRR. And he's not making any SAMe whatsoever, or he's making very little SAMe. And if he's not making very little SAMe, then he is not clearing out his dopamine pool, which is causing it to overflow. So what's happening is he's got way too much excitatory, not enough inhibitory, and that's why he has some depression. But he's focusing on Prozac as a solution, and it's working, it's making him feel better. But what is it doing to impact the iron absorption? What is it doing to help with the gut health? What is it doing to get more leafy greens and being able to make more folate, to be able to make more neurotransmitters? And most importantly, what is it doing to make the cofactor SAMe to clear out all that dopamine so he doesn't have all that excitatory mechanism? It's not doing much. And so there's a better way to go about this, and that comes down to lifestyle. That comes down to avoiding stressors as much as we possibly can, not trying to have 15 different windows open, going to bed earlier, avoiding your leaf, your synthetic, fortified, enriched cereals, breads, grains, stuff like that. Getting enough organic, because he had another enzyme, which is called PON1, which doesn't allow, both plus plus, that doesn't allow him to clear out the pesticides. So very important to remove pesticides, because those too can be excitatory, and he's got way too much excitatory and not enough inhibitory, and that's what's causing the majority of his depression. So before you just sort of run, and I think Prozac can be a really good supporting nutrient or medication, but are you actually getting to the root cause of the problem? And there's a lot of things we can do. We can help his absorption. We can get more leafy greens. We can get more iron support. We can get more tyrosine. We can get more SAMe. We can do all those things. And guess what? We didn't even address the serotonin side of things. Anyways, my name is Dr. Joel Rosen. I am the Adrenal Fatigue Recovery Ninja, and I look forward to helping end your kids' depression nightmare as well. Thank you so much.